Classroom engagement is something that we all teachers strive for. Whether it's a physical classroom or online classroom, we need engagement in the classroom, that is the interaction between the teacher and the students. Sometimes we get students to interact with us and sometimes we don't. That is why I have put together 5 tips for you to make sure that each and every session of yours is interactive. This video is going to be really value-packed, so make sure that you stay till the end of this video to get the full benefit from this video. Hi, I'm Joylyn Mathias, an educator helping fellow educators over here to leverage technology and teach effectively in their online classrooms. So let's begin with the video. The first tip that I want to share to boost your classroom engagement is keep your resources ready. By resources, what I mean is your worksheets, your teaching slides, and your assignments that you want to give them, or the videos that you want to show, or the articles that you want to give them to read. Keep them all ready before you begin your online session, because I don't want you to be searching during the classroom and make the students wait. That will decrease their attention span and they will think that, okay, the ma'am is now disturbed and we have a perfect chance to go on about and do our work. So they get distracted very easily. So keep everything ready, maybe in your taskbar, keep everything open and make sure you tell the students what we are going to do today. These are the points that we are going to cover today in this session. That makes them understand and they feel in control. Okay, now we are going to learn this and ma'am is going to teach this and that's it. When they don't know what they're going to learn, they are going to be scrambling around during your class thinking, what is ma'am going to teach? When is she going to finish? Or what are we going to learn? What are we not going to learn? They'll be thinking like that. So make sure that you tell them that today's agenda is so and so and keep your things ready. Now, the app that I suggest for this is Google Classroom. Google Classroom is perfect to teach online with all the resources over there. So whenever you are teaching, just open your Google Classroom and under classwork, you have your classroom there, right? And under that classroom, you have your classwork. And under the classroom, you can make some labels. And in that label, make a label called today's assignments and put all the assignments over there, which are due that day. And also you can attach some materials saying this is the video link that we are going to see, or all put all the video links and all the worksheets and assignments and articles under that. So it's easier for you to open right away from there and show it to them in the browser itself. So that makes your work a lot easier and children have a clear idea of what they're going to be doing that day, because they also can see in their classroom that ma'am has put all these assignments under the today's assignment label. So my next tip is going to be gamify your classroom. What it means is use games inside your session. By using games and making children play those games, but I don't mean any games, educational games, children will learn better. Also, when they are having hands-on experience, they learn better, they understand better, and they are also very much into that game. So they are engaged and they interact with you as well. And you can make it a very nice, like you can get the results live and it will be a fun session for them and they will want more. You know, they'll come back to your class and they'll say, ma'am, we want to learn like that. And you can give more games like that so that they learn better. Some apps that I suggest for this is Bluket, Kahoot, Quizlet. Now these are all kinds of quizzes which children can play online and you will get the live results of it. So children will like it and also it will be very educational because you can customize the games that are there in that. You can put your own questions and options. So it is tailored to your teaching and the subject that you're teaching. And for older kids, you can use quizzes and class time, which are very good and it keeps them engaged and they learn better. So now if you require a tutorial on these games or these quizzes, I'll be more than happy to do it, but I want you to put it in the comment box and then I will get on with it. Now my third tip for you to increase your classroom engagement is have a reward system. And by this I mean whenever a student turns in the assignment or some work that you've given them and they have done it, you make sure that you reward the students. maybe one student or all students collaboratively, reward them, say something good about it, good job, you have done it, and give them something. Maybe if it was a physical class, you would have given them a star or a smiley or something like a sticker, but online also you can give them something. Here are a few ways that you can reward them. First one is you can tell them to make a sheet, okay, and have a sheet, and every time ma'am tells, okay, put a star now in that sheet, ask them to draw a star, or ask them to buy the stickers, that set that they get, and ask them to take one sticker and stick it in that paper. That way they will be happy that, okay, ma'am gave me one star, even though you guys are far away, even the words that you say matters a lot. So the students will be very happy to draw a star and say, ma'am, I got 15 stars today, I got 16 stars. They will be thrilled. Another way of rewarding them is if you have a printer at home, or if you do not have also, you can trace the rewards that you want, maybe a smiley or a star or something nice, okay, and color it or make it like a physical, you cut it out and make it like a cutouts, and you can show the children. Maybe one student, pick one student, and that student has done the work. Now ask the student, which reward do you want? Now the student will say, I want that one, ma'am, third one. So you tell, okay, this reward is for you, and you keep it down there. You don't have to give it to him because it's online class, you can't give it to him. But the fact that the student has got that reward will make that student very happy. So you can keep like a five stickers and into two or three set. So that, you know, maybe more than one child would want the same reward. So you can do that way. Now, another fantastic tip to reward your students is have a dance party. Now, children love dancing in the classrooms, especially with their friends, even though online, but still, they would still like to do that. So what you can do is ask them their favorite song collaboratively and pick one which is of the majority and play it and let them have fun for a minute or two. And they will be so happy that ma'am has given a reward. So next time when you give them some work, they know that ma'am is going to reward them at the end of it. So they make sure that they will do this work. Okay, now this one is a really fun one. If you're teaching on Zoom, or if you're not also, call the children over Zoom and ask them to have a filter party. Now, there are a few filters in Zoom. You can ask them to choose any one of them and have a party, like 5 minutes. Children have a filter party and they are going to put all the filters possible and have a gala time. So make sure that you reward your students like this. Just let free for a session for 5 minutes. Let it go free, and children love it when you are open with them. Sometimes it's good to open up with your students so that they also open up and you can interact with them better. When your understanding increases with your students, when they start to trust you, like you, and understand you better as a teacher, you can understand them as a student, how they are, you can understand them better. So it is good to have parties and dances and themed parties like that to make your classroom a little bit interesting. Now the fourth tip for you to boost your classroom engagement is using breakout rooms. Now what are breakout rooms? For those of you who don't know, breakout rooms are nothing but groups of children put into different rooms. Now online we have sessions, right? One session that you're conducting. You can make like 5 students in one session, another 5 in another meeting, another 5 in another meeting. So those meetings are called rooms. They are breakout rooms. Now this is very nicely done in Google Meet. Google Meet has something called breakout rooms inside the meeting itself. You don't have to create anything outside it. So in that, with the students that are there in your list, Google Meet will give you options to select the students and then put them in the breakout rooms. Now you have 20 children. You can make 4 breakout rooms and give 5-5 each, or make 5 breakout rooms and give 4-4 children each. And you can select the children in Google Meet, and also you can assign a monitor so that the group doesn't discuss anything out of the topic that you give them. you can assign a monitor, and that monitor will make sure that the discussion is going on about that topic. And now you can allow them to discuss, or you can give them a Jamboard, okay, a specific Jamboard to that group itself, and you can tell them, okay, put all your points in this. So since they are online, they are going to come collaboratively put some points in that Jamboard. So like that, you can have your students discuss among themselves, and this also increases the engagement, because when students discuss with each other, it increases the interactions that they are having, okay, with their friends, with their students, and also with you. And you can go to each breakout room. You will have 5 links if you have created 5, and you can enter into that breakout room and see how they're discussing, and you can ask them and then come out and go to the other one. So it is great, like in your classroom, how they you are allowing them to have the discussion, same way you are allowing them to have it online. Now the fifth tip and the last tip that I'm going to give you to increase your classroom engagement is a very important one, is feedback. Okay, get your feedback from your students, and it is very important, trust me, because when students give you the feedback of how they felt the class was, you can improve the quality of your teaching, the way of your teaching. You will understand how you are, your students are learning. Okay, each and every student's learning way, learning style is different, and each of the batches that you teach, the previous batch would have learned in a different way. This batch is slightly a different one, because every year batches keep changing, because students are 1 year, you know, different from each other. So this batch might have a different style of learning. So it's always a good thing to get feedback from your students. Now you can do this in 2 ways. Like, you can give them a poll in Google Meet itself. There is a fantastic option to ask polls from your students. Now in this, what you can give is, you can give a question, how was the class today, and you can give them some options, and students will select it. Now this one was from my classroom, and students loved it, giving the feedback, and also they told me, ma'am, we learned this, ma'am, we learned that. And you know, this also is a part of an interaction after the session, after you finish teaching. Now this gives them the power to tell you that, ma'am, this is what I learned, this is what I didn't understand. So they're open to tell you what they did not understand. So this is a great way. Another way is using Jamboard. So you can give them the Jamboard link to them, and you can make it open to them, like share it with them and give them the access. And the children can select the sticky note and write. You can ask them, okay, students, now tell me, what did you learn about this topic today? So all of them are going to remember some topic, right? They are going to write it in the sticky note. You will get many answers, many repetitive answers, because they are going to write what they have understood. So that is another way where you can ask them to write everything in the sticky note and put it in the Jamboard. So these are the 2 ways you can use to take feedback. And another way is Google Form. Maybe after the chapter is over, when you're not in the session, you can ask them, send them this Google Form and ask them a few questions about the chapter and how was it, how did you understand, what you did not understand, what would have been better if, you know, what would you like to improve about it. You can ask like that, and children will give you the answers. So you can improve your teaching as well as interact with your students. First tip to boost your classroom engagement is keep your resources ready. Second one is to gamify your classroom. Use games in your classroom. Third one, use reward systems. Children love when you reward them and say good things to them. And the fourth one is to use breakout rooms, where you allow the children to have discussions among themselves. And the fifth one is to get feedback from your students, where they are going to tell you how this chapter was, or how the topic was, what they studied. So that is also a part of interaction. And now, as we come to the end of this video, I hope you like this and learn something new, and which you're going to use in your classroom and increase the classroom engagement. And if you found this useful, please like it and share it with your other teacher friends, so that they can also increase their engagement. Also, subscribe to this channel and hit that bell icon for more such videos. More videos are coming on online teaching, and also on designing worksheets in PowerPoint and Canva, and also editing your videos and pictures of your students and making them into a nice video for your assemblies and all the functions that you have at school. So all of that coming on this channel. So make sure you hit that bell icon and share this video with maximum people that you can. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.